This is Supermonaman shows the reworked version to Steins Gate, the movie. World region of deja vu, or burdened something of deja vu with the movie with translations. Orchestra music is it's burdened. That the one region is burdened something. Okay. First, I'm gonna go through the plot first. One thing about how on point science is its humor, wholesomeness, and horror elements. Psychological horror specifically, is what I mean. Well, the star from stands the wholesomeness and humor standpoint, but just something we can talk about more in detail at the end, maybe. By the time it's time for watching the plot, but stand well, stand up, so stand up here is just styles. They're all relatively soon after, so they're all the style was still point, it was great. So he was like, well, the first thing I was just the whole Daru and Yuki's Amane situation. Because we don't really have to like also, I'm talking so much of him just saying, he really trying to fuck on, trying to tell me, bitch. And there's such a new time, I see something in the past, I see such a new time, so. He's actually pretty hot. The daughter only sent a slightly photoshopped up close to a shot himself. Apparently, he's really kind of like, he can't just assume it's true. That means he looks so sad, to be honest. Now, the thing was, when they're all the first mean back to seeing operating. And Maxi and the whole that being two dairies pluck with each other and stubborn jackasses. So Oprah is really just she can a gift as well, give her a gift, give her the gift that you made for her. So it's a very special gift to me, a really sweet one to have you. Then Ferris and then also says that Everett like Daru and you and your are calling the fuck out of him to Gary. Star Wars hilarious and the show. And it turns out that the Orpian told him to come because he wanted to stop and barbecue so they can all celebrate together with each other. Just like, he's like, no, that's not all. Well, I guess I can do that because it's just fun. Yeah, during the barbecue, and he was sure that Mr. Brombach brought goddamn beer, even though he was supposed to be non-alcoholic because he brought all the goddamn beer. But also, like, in the background, Mr. Braun, and all we got just getting being drunk as fucking singing songs. It's just like, oh my god, this is amazing. It's all I ever wanted in this life, to be honest with you. But then, Moxie turns out to be a very flirty, touchy feeling drunk, very honest drunk. You took a bed and made me feel like asshole and fucking did that thing. She's here to, like, you told me you loved me, you're not a kid. She's here. Are you ashamed of me? It's like, this is how it looked like. And there's the whole really, really shitty, like, flurry interactions in the stairwell with Mercury trying very hard to not be doing them, because I feel like in his face, like, he's just like, you're drunk. like really drunk and you're not actually completely in control of yourself, so like really bring that, like doing something that would actually be taking advantage of you. There was a lot more humor in this movie. This is pretty awesome, pretty sad. Hot movie stuff. There were a lot of great hot movie talks in this. I'll get more to that later. But like, the very, like, some, when everyone steps up, just as they remember opening to the end of the credits, it's a very, really heartwarming just segment of the movie. I love it so goddamn much. I'll talk about that more later. But then we get to, like, the psychological horror stuff, which, I'll get more to that once I get into the story, basically. This stuff was fair. So I got myself being fucking awkward and dark dorks and some gay rays and shit like that. So some really wholesome dorks and shit like that. That was funny ones too. And then, I just think, alright, one more time we see this, like, one more time we see this episode, is when turns into the next thing, yeah, I guess it was a sphere of the Made in America, the American style. And once he was in camera, she was drunk. She drops the gift out of his pocket. She, and he reveals the gallon gift. It was personally engraved, so not a grand stone for her. So it's just Kate written to be for a rocky city. And we should look at least like we should really look at her. She's like, this is me. But then our parents took that intense goddamn subjects of past. Of past versions of past of other world minds and shit like that. Even so, once he wasn't, he didn't, he was never existing. Like the whole that horror scene with your operation of goddamn mental breakdown, like the psychological horror, and like you took a thinks like Mario doesn't die again, it's she more like a shining thing. There were also people like, what the fuck are you talking about? Like, there was like these terrorists scaring the shit out of them. He got a goddamn knife. He grabs a goddamn knife. Like, hold it to fucking Ron's just goddamn dicks. Like, they have to put him the fuck down, so we're in the science of time on there. We are? Oh god. This pause is just the way you feel like, you're like, what the fuck is happening? By himself, he starts seeing sensations all the way to the size of urine dies, which is just like a screaming. I think Mary shows a boring rather. Actually, Moxie shows a boring rather. It was a Mary Kelsey. Just to calm down and help him calm down shit out. And then I remember at this point, we don't see a mysterious figure following all around just an accident and the others. And the mysterious figure shows up from the shot now and give us 1 second of the voice and mission immediately. I was in a success. Well, I think it's still monkey. As we also get some oxygen carriers of cancer, it becomes, well, why shouldn't we? We all need some oxygen carriers of cancer, don't we? In the world, the just the one in the book, from the shadow of the door, and it's like a house. She's also under the hallucination in your father's hat, which I didn't realize it was your father's hat until later. I was like, oh, dumbass, you're so tall. Another new design. She's in the Sexist House. Well, obviously, it's the actual design. It's such a. I'm not working with bike your ass, which is doing much. It's like almost exercise gear, basically. Which is what the flex man is just sitting with cell phone, directly on the sink. Then she's like, I don't know what the flex man is going to do. I'm kind of losing the rest. She doesn't tell her to go watch her app. It went into Orca Rings. So I had Deja Vu, maybe you like Rings. I don't know. Like Rings, you don't have a really strong version of Deja Vu. As Rings are. Like most people have the memories of Rings. Actually, that's not a huge he can fish this game around a million miles. Does he really like it? Okay, so like, as he shows up, he's up with his doctor, he's also got. He heard something that was doing absolutely going to see this, like, the Santa or something. All that was. Like also antiseptic, it's like Jesus Christ. So she appears up her real thing. She got her a trailer truck. He does suddenly, she's holding the jacket. He had to hold, put the jacket back on, and just disappears and vanishes. She's got losing the fuck out. And she's losing her shit. Until the second time she tried to have a period, she got her mouth ring and then she falls and it's kind of something like that. She was, she did, she gets crushed on this. Yes, she was like, she gets the lab, like, she's losing, like, she's become crazy. But no one's ever, they all think, oh, I thought it was the leak. Well, right forehand to make the apology to have is it's like, but you know, she's just like that guy, because you can't remember his goddamn name, she always can't remember, she's like, why is this shit freaking out so much? And then, the next week, she's like, I'm missing. Something wrong with the goddamn world, and then potentially trying to get to clear. And there's weird things going on, like that don't make sense for why these characters would do certain things they're doing and shit like that. Like, the clue is that she has the mind grip talking about memories what he had sent to her, and he's like, remember him, and then also remembers that the person said to remember shit. Also, for some reason, the dog reacts to him, he doesn't understand why, and she like that. And she wants to be in 2 seconds, and she wants to be on time, and she like that. So he's back to him. So he's like, where's your razor? And then he's still like, he's back, he's like, how can I forget him? Like, he's like, he continues to disappear and reappear, like, constantly, he's like, it's like, fucking horrifying for Moxie and Green. And then the stranger shows up in Contact Earth. It's another version of Suzuha, because Suzuha just can't stop being a fucking great character because she's fucking Suzuha. Because she's Suzuha. Like this time she'll come to the past and save the world from losing her dream. Because Maki says built another time machine. She explains this to Mercury, she'll be like, she's having a feeling with this Virgo. She's like, that's, you know, just the constant disfigure. And she's only disfigured again. Explains it because of how strong the memories of different world lines. She's like, it's causing the time leap. Like, series on par with this, which we do on like over on time. It's very, very close to this one. It's 0.00001% off of this one. That's very sick. The find is the one that we're carrying on. It's like a 6% DNA. This was listed Mox Sheets. Mox Sheets, which you meant to give to all the hero, give them really great. I can remember that you might be able to forget the cement the fact that this science-gate robot says we don't have Orchard Fuses. And also, like, Orchard Fuses. Orchard may have a flat character arc. All the characters have flat character arcs, but that's only because they've already gone through their character arcs in the anime. This room is really because your actual character arc. Because your crazy character that's not flat. It's like being flat character arc is metal, honestly. Like, that was, like, Orphan's definitely a fusion trying to make. No. Time she's doing this great, time she's doing this great, because it's like. Because it's like, well, it's like in certain control worlds like that. It's like, because, like, do you know how it feels? Like, what? Like, why if you fail to save me? I'll tell you what you'll do. Fucking keep goddamn time and go through goddamn suffering I have to go through. Like, I want you to be your own peace. Like, all I want is wish for you and your own peace. That's all I got. I don't want anything else for it. Now, okay, it's just like, you have to forget me or something like that. It's like, that's she's just crazy refusal. She's just following around and like, my face just a very kissing. And like, that's just fair. How could you do that to me? That's the second time where she's like, where is she? She's just. I'll say she's like, she realizes she has to feel like, she has to wait, same way, she's right next to them, falls on her face, just crushing, she's like, seeing it like that, she's trying to. That's her lucky says. Definitely, she can tell me that she loves him, he disappears again. She's just literally breaking down in a holistic tear, like in it's like a heartbreaking breakdown, like emotional breakdown. She's like crying to herself and just like sobbing. And the performance is so, sobbing. I'm assuming the doctor is super fucking good for this movie, like, holy fuck. That crying scene, fucking Jesus. With our marriage, you know, she's like, I'm worried she doesn't try to tell me again. Like, it's like, it's okay, you don't have to get shit. Like, you know, just, I don't know what's going on, but I feel like you should try to do something like this. Got the pen and forget to fuck there and hack it. Get her more. So she just lets him check where he goes. His mission is shut down. And then it starts to mean that everyone without Orkery here is either upset or feeling upset at his mission just like them. Pen and forget he's actually a rival here for doing paint me too. Because of the last time, because. This movie is like, we have no way to look at the my entire situation for on shop. I'm like, yeah, 1 second, and since it's in the red, this is like, guys, you raised the red chain, but that's for the reason it's closing, it's because. That's because that's right, then. There is actually, way more sensitive than he probably should have. At least a lot of people do say, like, weird and nice and dark story, like, it's just your hassle to him, like, he's like, but he doesn't do it, that is, like, why you slightly care so much, it doesn't matter that much. So it's not a lot to sort of reduce him, you're gonna have me out there. So you just shows up to, like, say, like, why, how she came with the time she was here for why, which, what happened, like, I got, like, the fast versus feelings from arguing, so I thought it was really, honestly, like, it was actually really, like, good block, like, what's the word I'm looking for? It's really good philosophical question, and, like, a philosophical scene, basically, like, it's just the how you feel in science, and the facts like that, and stuff like that. How you truly feel right now, or what you want to do. Not feeling changes, like, do take time to change, but you make sure that you make sure with my father that's completely forbidden to use the lost mic forever. So you don't, not really, you break, cause you don't care, you stop certain shit like that from happening ever. That's like, no, I promise that, like, I'm just like, almost. So he slaps her down, she's like, what can we do this problem? She's like, you're always goddamn like this. Do you really want to trust the scientist, your scientist, thoughts, or do you want to trust how you feel? What the fuck? And she's like, because of it, like, she has the kids' case to come down with you. The first one is a little hard, so you're trying to feel that. That's what the whole argument would be like. You're going to pretend she don't have much, no matter what happened, you're going to do this, so why should you try to stop and shit like that? That's just a thing, how, like, you've had a problem with your operating in the past. So you can, like, say, if someone's to work, this starting to get more lines, a real one. Damn. Because, I'm curious, you're sure you don't, like, said crazy months coming into the time, but I think there was 13 hours. I think Mercury was 13 hours a year. Maybe it's like 12. In fact, Mercury was still grieving and he kept, as he starts talking, then unfortunately she trips and falls in the middle of the street off to kill him, and she gets saved by Ocarina, like she can die for no reason. She's like, when we get back to the regular world line, she just is just on the ground in just absolute shock and terror and absolute, like, just I can't go to the fast one trigger, like, shit, I'm so powerful. I was just like, that'll just end up leading me to. I get back to the right way to look at getting killed again. I know where I can feel it. Also, I actually make a picture of Zeke. Honestly, I think I'm putting a picture of the whole cast to be honest with you. Yeah, I'm gonna put a picture of the whole cast and a picture of like me up again in like the other world line, because you went through into Maximum world, the size of your world line was both over pretty much in like face to face and back to back and we're seeing for us. Then watching as it comes back to the future, like, person, like, how it looked. Absolute psychological fuck, mind fuck out of here, too. It's just like, I love that Moxie has, like, I actually love that Moxie has to go through this, like, at first I got something weird about this and some shit, too. But the fact that Moxie had to go through the same shit Ocarina does, shines her relationship even more, like, I love this version of Moxie, this is how all the memories that. he has just the fragments to be like to really show to deepen the relationships like that. And relationships story that Mary and everyone else do. Like watch the first or your first like you know, okay, like you see this thing where you're like, I don't know what it means and like who it is and what my expression about she's like my sister was like my sense of like there's no she goes she's like anyone else's or anything like that. I would go reverse. Ferris, you know, as if I'm trying to Ferris was Darwin. My way care is just like very just like it feels like something missing, doesn't it? With Ferris, I'm trying to play against someone mind that like someone is like you're starting to prepare for she's sticky off. So it starts doing like it. She starts actually putting on the laptop and doing it. She puts on the persona. We take a shot Kelly and Kiyama. She also can marry someone. She's like, as like Eric thought, she's like, do she can't do some promising, right? But she's like, I can't, no, I have to work behind him. She's like, that's how man should, that's how the man's life, man's life is going. She's like, because everyone feels that way about the change or anything. She once again goes too fast, but just like to say, oh, what the hell are you doing? Remember, you're saying, trying close to the deal, you'll just lead to his death, right? But then, brains not too fast, it's just wait, he ends up right in time, realizing she feels just as like aggressive, unsure of who she is. She just starts finding the whole thing out of my. My friends really hurting me, like I don't know what to do, and I just feel really kind of useless. And then Roxy implants the cluster from Kiyama into Okami's mind, which playing full circle again. It was what led him to dying up for sure in the first place to help Mary detect him to like. Allow her time to breathe easily without losing herself. Sorry, like, he was like, he was crazy. He said, don't believe this idea, so he's pretty much crazy like that. But now everyone else, he's the only one who sees the truth about the UK. Seriously, he's just like, that's really sense right now. I think the people. Then gives him his first kiss. Which Arkham gives, brings up even when she goes to bring up the rest of the Steins at Broadline. And she's just like, you're gonna give me my first kiss like whatever. And like, I remember sitting back in the other show, I was like, are they first, they did first kiss, she's like, this was my first kiss I had. She didn't remember what next to the fact was so long ago. What a romantic concept. So it finishes, it makes him come to this world for good. The same person is like, okay, come back up. Like, are you trying to get into this world now? Or are you trying to come back to our world life? Like, so I think they're face to face. It's like, they're moving back to that. I think they're face to face. With like a traffic line divide. That was like, but then, like, when he slowly comes back into the side view. Online, it's the transition shows like there's a crazy giant crowd going all around them. It's like, how's it anything? So it's also the opening crowd theme and like the animation even shown there. And, like, there's nothing there with the world lines and like this concept of science and stuff like that. It's really cool. The anything being like this much of this stuff. Of the love between Mercury and Max and the love between all the others, and Mercury and each other is so good. And all that I love them a lot. Like this scene, just the fact, like, it was so heartwarming to see this scene inside Mercury and Kiyama, and that he was like surprising me. Like, you seem very lost, just like, oh, yeah, that's right. sleep behind you. No one will remember. Everyone still remembers him. No one wants to do the imitation of his medicine. Because for some reason, it's just like, oh. That one, to be able to help me or get through grief, is just like, wow, that's really impressive. That's really heartwarming impression. I love it a lot. Yeah, of course. Also, that first fight is very comforting. It's like, oh, Romeo, is it true again? It's our character again. Kazu's always very. Tell Kazu Shiki is Daru. So, you might ask Kirisu. Actually, Sayori. Goto, his Roika. You, Kobayashi, is Ruka. Kako. Mamoy is Sheris. Damn, yeah, Jesus Christ. Yukari, tomorrow is Shizuka. Often it's like, those voices are falling so goddamn cool. It's really special in this movie to have to do. And that's just like, and the character work from Maxi Hang, this is so similar shit to Okri, like, I'm not. I got my hero shirt instead. Deku, Bakugo, and Tsuruki. Gets Tsuruki, unfortunately. Different color cards. Green, yellow, and white. Sorry. Tell them to that. But yeah, the character works in the same shirt. Like, that's a lot of scale, sure. Except her understanding of what Green had gone through and suffering. They went through, like, the whole is like, dude, Zerg, be happy. You just play stronger, stronger than that. He's like, don't do it, Zerg. It's time. Fuck you, time, basically. It's like, the whole movie. The only other characters are like, this is not actually like, all the fuck. Like, this is called Ace, and I'm still remembering Ocarina. I'm pretty sure he was much in line with what all the shit he wanted. Down to the anime is really great. And I also have some character options because there are some characters not in the anime. And actually, have a character option in the anime, but this one seems more like have the two symptoms opening there, which is really well, very, like, I actually really enjoyed that. How that contrast, how similar the most of the opening to made them like, how you watch all the series is what's really the rest of the struggle that you liked. Then the character that watch it leads to her inspiring more crazy than what it's really well done. Amazing, I loved it so much. And the fact that, like, Jinzo, at least without more crazy, Jinzo actually pulled a song, was so great. Really well done. Music is such like, sure, music is very much most shown for most of the anime so far. It's probably the anime so far. But, like, I think there was at least some remixes of at least one remix in the PLC, so goddamn good if you mix it with the name of. Target to the stint of the other than the name of that song, the goddamn song, to be honest with you. Okay, anything else? Like, I love this, like, even horrifying the look, the psychological horror and existential dread of this movie, really want that, like, really, it's like, it's probably really scary for the character, they raise the stakes and shit like that. Just something like that, was like, even like, shut up, the movie's in worship, it's gonna script the fuck out of that. It was actually fun, dude. It was like, the was like, yeah, somewhere. I was like, I see the other people, like, yes, you're entertaining me. I can sell some of them, we should buy shit. So, anyways, that's nice to ask you. Anyways, there's just like a upgrade moon version of the game, which never really got me in, which is just like, that is fucking great, because I actually really enjoy the animations in the series, to be honest with you. Like, so it's like the line, like, you get used to the line at first, but like, once you get used to it, you're like, just really, you're all in, really into it, which is like, what's great about it, what's great about it. Like, the emotional mental breakdown of the character is just really well done, too. And the performance is even great, because that's the last parts. Yeah, I was gonna say, this is a really great, well-made movie. The time that you fit into the plot of the anime, time is back again to some stuff in the beginning, dude. You should link to the description, and I can't wait till I get some alternate version of Twister 3 and Steins at Zero at some point. I don't know. I'll believe you soon. Anyway, that was great. I can't wait to see what comes next. At the end of the video, I would like to thank all my current subscribers on YouTube, all my current patrons on Patreon. And if you enjoyed the video, please like and comment if you like. And if you enjoy my channel, please subscribe. And you find the links to my current Patreon video I'm watching, as well as the redirect to the reaction itself down below in the description. If you'd like to join Patreon, please do, and I'll be keep continuing to enjoy my content. And finally, as my favorite and if you're on Tribute Crew, just in the talking, let's say sayonara, bye-bye.